Hello, I'm Jumat. In this video, we will focus on how to understand better the champion we play, targeting his strengths and weaknesses. More so, we will talk about some resources to see which champions work in the current meta, and how to find your counters, and where to find a guide for your chosen champion. There will also be provided a practical example in a high diamond game with Cassidy. Welcome to the third episode of the Plays Explained series. Every matchup is either one-sided or balanced, a skill matchup to some sort. In order to minimize weaknesses and maximize strengths, you should pick a champion that thrives in the current meta. The meta in gaming is a defined set of effective strategies for a specific multiplayer game. For example, if you pick Soraka support top, you might ruin the current team comp and you'd oblige the others to adhere to your current playstyle, which is unacceptable in most cases. An unofficial definition for meta in gaming could be most effective tactics available, but I didn't see it referenced in many places, so take it with a grain of salt. For the current patch 7.13, ArcSecond made a nice video about the meta in which he presents a document that represents the S tier, A tier and B tier champions for this current meta, obviously. I will post the video link also in description. These champions are more useful than the rest for their respective roles because they are influenced better by the current meta. Some were probably recently buffed, some never changed and remained at the top, see Agri for example. Most champions that are S tier in the current meta shine in multiple moments of the game. These moments are well known and defined as early, mid and late game. If you don't know where your champion shines, just search for guides for said champion by someone who's at least diamond or higher, or watch pros, pro play and so on. Your main job when playing a champion is to know and to understand when is the moment in which your champion reaches his full potential, when he is the most useful for the current team comp you play with. You should also have a general idea about the matchups for your champion, who counters you and who does not. One resource you can use here is statistics. For example, if you'd use champion.gg, for any champion you pick there are some champions listed that against your champion have a 50% or higher win rate. Therefore, theoretically, some of these champions counter yours. You should obviously need to know more than one champion when playing solo queue in order to evade some counters, although, for mid lane, very few champions have hard counters, so it's not impossible to survive the lane phase. Opponent's skill is also a factor you should take in consideration when playing against an enemy that you theoretically counter or he counters you. Let's move to a more practical example now. In this game, I am playing Cassidy against Kyle on mid lane. Cassidy starts to be at least decent at level 6 when he gets his ult, but his real power starts after Lich Bane, which is his second item or third if you consider boots. Kyle is a decent counter to Cassidy at least early game. As you can see, my goal is to stall and just farm until I reach Lich Bane and only to engage if I get an exceptional gank or such. I am in no position to actually defeat my opponent in lane this early, and so I have to play as defensive as I can and obviously to not feed. Most people skip this last part, am I right? After 6, I would have a chance to kill Kyle with jungle's help, but for counter ganking purposes I mostly choose to play over defensively and get my kills on other lanes if possible. Also, a first key point of the game is this Infernal Drake that we got for free. Moving forward, the game is in our favor and I'm close to Lich Bane, but it is not yet decided because of the good kill distribution in the enemy team between Kyle and Draven, which are both hyper carries. As I said before, know your purpose and when is the moment where your champion shines. I know I am slowly becoming a huge threat for them, and so I dive head on after I finish my Lich Bane on unsuspecting targets or on Kyle. Their top laner seems to do a better job as a split pusher with his ult than ours, so we are at a disadvantage in terms of strategy. However, their hyper carries get often caught and thus ruining any possibility of a good outcome in order for them to win the game. A mistake Yorick also does is not recalling when it's absolutely necessary. At this point, with Kyle being caught, the game is pretty much over, as we can take at least a free inhibitor and snowball from there even further. However, with a solid 4-man defense, they could have kept the game longer, and with a proper engage they might even turn it around. But this is absolutely not the case. Also, never split push when your base is getting destroyed, unless you can actually win a base race. In conclusion, with the help of other resources, I've presented the theory before any champion you'd pick, the champions that adhere to the meta, the moments of the game, and provided enough links which I urge you all to check if you want to improve and to climb faster in League of Legends. All champions have strengths and weaknesses, and you need to know at which time your champion shines and what is his purpose. Take the example in case, Kassadin is a late game monster, a counter to most AP mids and a good roamer, at the cost of a bad early game which is mostly sustained by teleport and the risk of facing some AD counters or even AP sometimes. Again, remember, in order to understand better a champion, you have to study in which strategies he fits, in which moments he shines, in which roles he does best, and what are his strengths and weaknesses. Obviously, learn the proper setup for runes, masteries, and items as well. Hopefully, these guidelines will provide enough help, or at least directions to start climbing easier and reach your goals. Thanks for watching.